Good morning, students. Welcome to lecture number 25, Introduction to Arc Welding Process, GMAW process, that is gas metal arc welding process. So this is objective of this study is a brief about the GMAW process. So you will come across the terms like MIG process, MAG process, metal transfer modes, effect of polarity in welding, advancements of GMAW welding, GMAW process. So what is GMAW processes? It is similar to the arc welding processes you have come across so far. So far we have seen the SMAW process, SAW process, CAW process, etc. In those processes, the shielding is provided with the help of a flex. Either flex coated on the electrode or arc submerged under a heap of your flex material, etc. Whereas in the case of gas metal arc welding process, here also the shielding is provided with the help of external supply of shielding gas. Okay, the shielding is done with the help of external supply of shielding gas. So like SMAW process or SAW process, in this process also it uses a consumable wire electrode and you require a power source. Okay, you require a power source. Normally inverter type power sources are used for GMAW welding process. So, as you can see, in the case of power source, normally the power source used will be of inverter type power source. So, we will see its details one by one. So, in the case of a GMAW process, a wire electrode is fed continuously and automatically from a spool through the welding gun. So, you can see over here welding torch, and this is a wire electrode which is going to get melted and deposited in the molten weld puddle and then solidifies to get your weld puddle. So this is the arc which is strike in between your positive and negative terminals of your supply. So here the another advantage of GMAW process is gas mixtures can be used. That is, shielded gas need not to be of single type. Multiple combinations of shielding gas you can provide so that the advancements in the weldings are possible. And here no electrode coating is done. The filler wire whatever you are using is a bare electrode, so the shielding will be surrounded by from the sides of the nozzle so as to ensure that no atmospheric contaminants will get deposited into the joint. And the peculiarity of the GMAW process is self-adjusting arc. That is, when I talked about the CV and CC power sources in the last classes, I have given you an example that where this GMAW falls. Okay, so normally CV power sources will be used in the case of GMAW process, that is called as the self-adjusting arc process. So DC is used. You can have the two options, electrode positive and electrode negative. So normal configuration is shown over here. You can achieve different modes of metal transfer in the case of GMAW process. We will discuss later. No flex or additional filler wire is not required since this itself will get melted and deposited. So high current density and higher welding speeds are the uses, or I can say are the benefits of the GMAW process. So in detail, if we see this GMAW process, based on the shielding gas you are supplying, the process can be classified as metal inert gas welding or metal active gas welding. That is, if we are using the inert gases like argon or helium alone, that process is called as metal inert gas welding process. So non-ferrous metals like aluminium and copper, you need only the shielding of argon and helium. So if I am blending this argon with CO2 or with O2 etc. Okay, that process is called as metal active gas process. Okay, in short, we will written as MAG process. So MIG and MAG are the two variants of process which falls under the category of GMAW process. And normally ferrous metals, especially all types of steels, will be welded with a blend of CO2 plus argon, where maximum portion will be of argon and minor portion will be of CO2. And normal case, that will be 80:20. Argon will be 80% and CO2 will maximum go up to 20%. Okay, lesser variations or combinations are also possible. Depends on the steel, depends on the application. You have to choose the right combination of the welding, shielding gas supplies. So if we see the system components, you can see there will be one or two cylinders. Depends on what all gases you are used. Maybe sometimes one cylinder alone. Why? Because certain cases pre-mixed cylinders are also available in the market. So a shielding gas supply is required. You can see that shielding gas will be connecting to your weld gun. Okay. So this is your weld gun. And you can see this is your wire spool. And where you can see this is a wire electrode. Okay, the electrode is fed continuously from a wire spool through the various guiding mechanism, and that will be passing through the sender of your welding gun through your nozzle. So the surrounded area of this nozzle, okay, that will comes with the supply of the shielding gas. So depends on the application, the gas is going to vary. Okay. And you can see it's a power source. So power source will have both plus and minus terminals will be there. We have seen earlier also, we can see DC EP or DC EN. Based on the condition, you can connect this to positive or to negative terminal. So this is a ground clamp. Ground clamp will be normally connected to your weld table, and this will be kept on top of your weld table. So like the other arc welding process, here also the working principles are same. That is, the electrode is kept at certain distance apart, and as a result the arcing will takes place, and continuous arcing will takes place, ensure a proper weld you can able to obtain in the case of GMAW process. So you can see over here, weld current adjustments are possible. Weld current taps are also available. So for further measurements, etc., that are also possible. Voltmeter and ammeter will be also present on the system, so as to adjust or so as to correct to view our required, was it going in the correct sense or not. So that can be observed from the voltmeter or from the ammeter. So the other parts like cylinder valve, safety nuts, wire spool is shown, feed rolls are shown, gas hose is shown. Okay, so this is the ground lead. So these are the typical part, complete part of the GMAW system components. So flow meter is required to adjust the flow. Normally flow we will be measuring in terms of LPM. So whether it is 10 LPM or 20 LPM like that. So normally by default it is 20 LPM. Not correct. They will be varying on ranges. I'll show you in the next slides. So safety nets are ensuring that any malpractice happens. So any pressure is heaping in the cylinder, so that has to be removed off. So for that, safety nets are there. And you can see this is the wire spool, as I told you. Okay, through the guiding mechanism, that will be passing through this gun over here. Now we will cut short from the machine to the arc. So you can see in the case of GMAW process, this is a typical welding torch, and center of the torch you will have the nozzle, and through this area the consumable wire electrode is being fed continuously. These are the areas inside the nozzle where the shielding gas is being supplied. So you can see the entire arc is protected under the shielding gas, and this is the area where the liquid metal is present. Normally we call it as weld pool or molten weld puddle, and this is the welded area. So weld is taking place in this direction. So this is the parent metal. Okay, this is a parent metal, and these are the area where the welding is going to takes place. So you can see over here, here also the electrode is kept at certain distance apart. It is not touched to your workpiece. So working principle is same as that of your previous arc welding process is applicable here also. The difference between your SMAW process and GMAW process is that in the case of GMAW process, the electrode is continuously fed from a wire spool, and the shielding is provided with the help of shielding gas. Whereas in the case of SMAW process, you have only limited length electrode is available, and you can see to that, the shielding is provided based on the coating of flux which is available or which is coated on the top of your electrode. If we compare with SAW process and this, SAW process and this, the similarity is that both will use non-coated electrode, where the in the case of SAW process, all the arc is happening inside the heap of your flux material, whereas here the shielding is done with the help of shielding gas. The similarity between both the processes is that both will use the electrodes from a wire spool. Okay, and both are non-coated electrodes, that is bare electrode, both will use consumable electrode. Okay, so rest all process wise all are same. So now we'll see the, now we can see the important parts in the case of GMAW process. The typical nozzle is shown. The first is electrode, the second is marked as the arc, third is your weld puddle, the fourth is the shielding gas, and fifth is the solidified metal. So this is a travel direction. Okay, so generally drag on thin sheet metal and push on a thicker material. So that is the travel direction, normal travel direction, drag direction on thin sheets and push in the thicker material. You have to choose for the travel direction. Now we'll see one by one what all things we have marked here. So electrode, you can see the electrode is, as I told you, it is comes as spools or reels, okay, of coils ranging from 1 lb to 1000 lbs. You can see, okay, this is the larger one and you can see this is the smaller one. So like this, many welding electrode manufacturing companies are there. They will provide you the reels. You have to purchase in a reel like this as your welding electrode. So GMAW electrode is a metal wire fed through the gun by the wire feeder measured by its diameter. So that is the characteristics of the electrode. Okay, and there is a life period also will be mentioned for each and every wire reel. Beyond that, if you try to use, it will try to get bend or break inside the guiding mechanism itself. So the next one is electric arc. So electric arc occurs in a gassed filled space between the electrode wire and the workpiece. Electric arc can generate temperature up to 10,000 degree Fahrenheit. So you can see over here, this is your arc, and you can see in between over here, the electrode is being melted and being deposited into the joint. So that is also lightly you will be able to see over here. More videos I'll show you in the coming slides. So this arc again, so the amount of temperature can be varied based on the condition of gas metal arc, DCEP welding or DCEN welding. Here you have to understand that whatever the way in which it appears in GMAW process, there is another process is called GTAW process that will be reversed. For example, in the case of DCEP, electrode positive, you have connected the positive terminal to your electrode and negative to your workpiece. So the resultant weld will have a deeper penetration like this. Why? What happens? You can see the flow of ions, the positive ions is from your positive to negative. As a result, more amount of heat will be accumulated on your work piece. As a result, you will get a deeper penetration in the case of GMAW process. Whereas if I take a GTAW process, that is a TIG welding process, for a DCEP welding process, you can see to it the penetration won't penetrate, you will not get a penetration like this. Okay, the penetration will be poor or reverse in the case of GTAW welding process. So the flow of ions and flow of electrons is marked over here. So DCEP, so electrode is positive and work is negative. So provides maximum heat input into the work, allowing relatively deep penetration to take place, assist in removal of oxides from plate, low current value produce globular transfer of metals from electrode, shielding gas must contain a minimum of 80% argon, ferrous metals needs of addition of 2 to 5% of oxygen to gas mixture. So that is a condition of DCEP welding process. So when I talk about DCEP, the next one will be DCEN. So DCEN, you can see the flow of ions is towards your electrode side. As a result, more amount of heat is accumulated at the tip of your electrode. As a result, the electrode, the detachment of your droplet from the electrode will be much of higher in size. Okay, as a result, you will get the bead width. Okay, the bead width, okay, a wide bead width is you can able to obtain in the case of DCEN power source. So that is just opposite to gas tungsten arc welding. In tungsten arc welding, you will get a deeper penetration in the case of DCEN configuration. Whereas in the case of GMAW process, here the resultant configuration will be like this. Your weld bead width will be higher in the case of DCEN configuration. So limited use of welding of thin gauge material. So thin sheets, if you want to weld, you can go for DCEN configuration. So greatest amount of heat occurs at electrode tip. Wire melt off rate greater deals faster than DCEP. Okay, that is because more amount of heat is accumulated on the electrode. As a result, melt off rate of wire is higher and faster. Penetration is also less than with DCEP. Reason I told you. So more heat is accumulated over here. As a result, less penetration is taking place. Arc not stable at the end of the filler wire. Corrected by use of shielding gas mixture of 5% oxygen added to argon. So melt off rate reduced. So benefit is cancelled. So that is the way. That's the way you can do some experiments on DCEN, and you can able to see to it how a better efficiency in the weld you can able to achieve. So when I talk about DC, don't think that DC alone can be used, since normally we are going for inverter type of power source. So in the inverter type of power source, we will have DCEN as well as DC as well as AC. So you can shift to AC also, but AC normally not recommended in the case of GMAW process because of the unstable arc. The current is reversing on every half cycle, so the arc is unstable. Okay, so when we are going for AC, we can see that combination of both DCEN and DCEP polarity, rate of metal transfer and depth of penetration falls between those polarities. And in the case of welding of aluminium alloys, alternating current in GMAW process has found some application. Okay. So that is about the arc. Now we move to the third part, that is the molten weld puddle. You can see this is the state where the molten material is available. So the liquid metal is present, that is called as the molten weld puddle. So this is a typical nozzle, and this is the wire extended out, and here is the area where the arcing is taking place, and this is called as a molten weld puddle. As a wire electrode and workpiece heat up and melt, they form a pool of molten material called as weld puddle. This is what the welder watches and manipulates while the welding is happening. So welder can watch, and based on that he can see that whether the weld is going on the guided direction or any deviation is happening in the guided direction or not, that can able to observe. The welder normally watches this puddle, and any change or corrections if he want to make, he can manipulate over here if the direction is changing. Or he can also view to it, and you can see that whether a proper welding is taking place or not, he can view it, or he can adjust the welding parameters by observing this molten weld puddle. So the next part, that is called as shielding gas. I already given you a detailed description about the shielding gas. So shielding gas, we can use the inert gas. If inert gas alone is used, once again I'll tell you, we call the processes metal inert gas welding, MIG process. If we are combining CO2 or O2 etc. with the inert gases like argon etc., we call that process as MAG process. So in the case of shielding gas, the outlet pressure normally set at to 1.5 to kg per centimeter square, and flow rate of your gas will be 15 to 20 lpm. So flow rate will be adjusted on the flow meters. By seeing the flow meter, you can adjust the flow. Pressure gauges will be fitted on your cylinder. So from the pressure gauge, you can set your outlet pressure also. So this is what is recommended values for welding various materials under GMAW process. So welding requires a shielding gas to protect the weld puddle. Shielding gas is usually CO2, argon, or a mixture of both. So that's about the shielding gas. Once everything is done, you can see a proper bead you can able to observe in the weld metal. Once the liquid metal in the molten metal solidifies, you can see a solidified weld metal is shown over here, where a uniform marking of ripples you can observe on the weld if it is a good and uniform weld. So the figure above here is a weld which is done on a material of aluminium with GMAW process. Okay, and since you are not using any flux here, the shielding is done with the help of gas. No slag will be present on the top of your weld bead, so that no chipping is not required. So chipping is required normally in the case of SMAW process, that is not required in the case of GMAW process. So it's a slag free weld you can able to obtain in the case of GMAW process. Now we will see what are the process variables of GMAW process. So the main process variables, welding variables, will be wire feed speed. Okay, or we can call it as the welding speed also. So the rate in which the wire feed is being happening. The next is voltage. Next is current. So normally voltage and current, both will have a variable. You will set only one, the another will automatically draw accordingly. That is what is called as the self-regulating characteristics of the arc means. If you set the current, voltage automatically will draw accordingly. Okay, if you set the voltage, higher current will be drawing accordingly. Then the operator controlled variables are travel speed, gun angle, contact tip to work distance CTWD, and gas flow rate. Okay, so you can see this is the area where the wire feed speed WFS can be set over here. Here also it is shown you to set the voltage. So accordingly, when you set the voltage, the current will be drawn. Accordingly based on its proportion already designed in the transformers or rectifiers. So we'll see the factors one by one in a detail. The major important factor in all the welding as well as in GMAW process is welding current. So welding current is controlled, or the factors that affect on the welding current is wire diameter. You can see the typical 3 diameter wires are shown over here, which are normally used in the GMAW process of 0.8 mm, 1.2 mm, and 1.6 mm. You can see the variations in the current. Okay, if you take any constant wire feed rate, you can see the variations in the current which is required to melt or burn off that wire to get deposited. So as the diameter is increasing, you can see more amount of current is required to melt in the case of a constant wire feed rate. If the wire feed rate is increasing, you can see the range of current is much higher, increasing much higher to melt the electrode and being getting deposited into the well joint. So wire diameter, wire material, feed rate and standoff distance are the factors that affects in the selection of weld current. So what is this CTWD? So contact tube to work distance. You can see this is the area inside the nozzle from which the electrode is kept open. So from this position to the height at which your workpiece is kept, that is called as contact tube to work distance. Okay, this is called as contact tube to work distance, CTWD. Okay, so this is the distance. So you can see over here, as the contact tube distance is increasing, the current is also increasing in the other way. So CTWD increases. Okay, more amount of current is required. Sorry, CTWD decreases. Okay, CTWD decreases, the standoff distance decreases, more amount of current is required to melt your welding electrode. You can see over here, this is a typical characteristics drawn for a 1.2 mm diameter electrode where 82% of argon and 18% CO2 is used as the shielding gas. Arc voltage is 29 volt, the set parameter. Wire feed speed is 8.8 meter per minute and weld speed is 58 centimeter per minute. In that case, if I vary the CTWD alone, you can see there is a change in the current is happening. So current is changing. For a CTWD of 30 mm, it is 250 amps. When it comes to 10, a CTWD value as 10 mm, this distance, if I am reducing to 10 mm, current is increasing somewhere to 350 amps. So CTWD is another parameter which influences your current condition for a set voltage. You have set voltage only 29 volt, but you can see the change of current is happening as when the standoff distance is varying. Oh, sorry, as the contact tube work distance is varying. So there is one more term will be there called standoff distance. So standoff distance will be taken from this position to this. What is the length? That is called as a standoff distance. So that is also taken in the case of some welding process for designing or fixing the parameters. So you can see here I kept the voltage as 29, and when I change the CTWD distance, the current is automatically drawing. So this is called as the self-regulating characteristics of the GMAW process. Okay. So that is one of the best advantage why GMAW process has been used in majority of all kind of fabrication industries. Okay, so 80 to 90% we will use GMAW process recommended in the industries. Now the selection of arc voltage, factors to be considered as current, vice versa. Okay, mode of metal transfer, shielding gas and standoff distance. So the CTWD is shown here. Standoff distance is a different term. So standoff distance is nothing but, you can see over here, from this point, from the tip of your nozzle, the distance to your workpiece, that is called as the standoff distance. Whereas the electrode is extending out from your nozzle to your workpiece, that height is called as CTWD. And the empirical relation for selecting your voltage, for short arc and spray arc is shown over here. I'll discuss these terms in the coming slide, so you will get an example what do you mean by the term called as short arc and what do you mean by the term called as spray arc. Okay, and this is, we already discussed this, I hope you remember this, in the case of constant voltage power source, which is normally recommended in the case of MIG welding. So change in the voltage is negligible, whereas the change in the current is higher. You can correlate that with respect to the previous slide also. Okay, the 3 CTWD distance or the 3 wire characteristics, as the change is happening, more higher amount of current has been drawn than compared to the change in the voltage. So that is also called as the self-regulating characteristics of arc in the case of GMAW process. Yeah, so this is called as a standoff distance. Okay, from the complete tip of your welding gun, whatever is projected out, that distance is called standoff distance. And somewhere around here, your nozzle will be ending. From there to here, the height, that is called as the CTWD distance. So height should be less than 180 amps for a stick out distance of 8 to 12 mm. I greater than 180 mm for the stick out distance of 14 to 18 mm. So these all are some kind of empirical relations. After conducting lot many trials in the industries, okay, it has been established. So these are some empirical relations or some guide values for you to fix the standoff distance or the current. So now we'll come to the one of the important or the most popular terms, why GMAW is most popular for the industries. That is the modes of metal transfer available in GMAW process. So the modes of this, since the various modes are available in the GMAW process, which enables it to use from all kind of material application. That is, if you want to weld a thin sheet, it is possible. If you want to weld a thicker plate, solutions are available in GMAW process. That is why in the case of all fabrication industries, you can say GMAW processes widely used. So the modes of metal transfer which are available in the GMAW process are short circuit transfer, globular transfer, spray transfer, and pulsed spray transfer. Okay, you can see the modes of metal transfer is determined by a number of welding variables such as voltage, amperage, and shielding current. So in the case of short circuit transfer, this is a simple figure. I'll show you a running video in the next slide. So in the case of a short circuit transfer, it is of low power, and you can employ this in the case of thin sheet welding. Whereas in the case of globular transfer, it is medium power sheet only. For flat position, you are able to weld by using this process. Spray transfer, it is high power, high deposition, and good penetration, but it is, you, since of high energy, thin sheets are not recommended for this spray transfer. So the mix of this globular, spray, etc., you have made a modified process that is called pulse spray transfer. So pulse spray transfer is recommended from thin sheets to thick plates. This pulse spray transfer is recommended. Okay, so we will see one by one in little detail. So you can see this is actually a high speed photography. A high speed photography converted into a video which resembles your the melting of your wire electrode being impinged from your electrode tip and being deposited into the molten well puddle, and later it is attaching into the molten well puddle and finally solidified. You will get here as a welded joint. Why this is called as short circuit transfer? Because you can see when the droplet starts to detach from your electrode, it is touching your well puddle. So when it is touching your well puddle, you can see the shorting is taking place. Okay, so that is the reason why this mode of power transfer, it is called as short circuit transfer, short circuit mode of metal transfer, where we will employ low current and low voltage. So thin sheet welding and all position weldings are possible in the case of short circuit transfer. You can also observe here the diameter of the droplet which is forming and the tip of your electrode, the size is smaller. So the size is smaller because you can observe that is because of the low current and low voltage settings which are happening here. So droplets transferred during short circuit, weld pool of high viscosity, about 70 droplets transferred per second. As a result of high viscosity, what happens is that sometimes this molten material may not fall into the weld puddle. It may fallen into any other areas over your weld plate. So the figures, on a detailed figure you can show over here, when the molten metal is detaching from the electrode, both the plus and negative terminals are touched. That's why it is called as shorted, and that is called as short circuit transfer. And if you study the transients of current and voltage of this, I have shown you in the next slide, so you can able to observe this properly. So if you want to set the short circuit, so short circuit normally will be setting in this range. So high voltage, about 25 volt is required to set for short circuit. And you can see this is the process selection and this is the recommended area where the short circuit is recommended. So this is shown for the typical case of a wire electrode of 1 mm diameter. Okay, protective shielding gas is used with the electrode specification and shielding gas mixture is shown over here. Now there's a typical characteristics of current and voltage in the case of short circuit. So you can see this is a short circuit. So when a short circuit is happening, you can see voltage is going to zero. Okay, voltage touches to ground, current is also dropping. Then when it is detached, when the short circuiting is happening and when it is getting detached, you can see the current rises again into a higher value. Okay, short circuit cycle, rising current. Okay, arcing cycle, current decay. So corresponding figures are shown over there in the bottom. So diminishing, short circuit, necking, reignition, standing current arc and diminishing. So again it comes into this position. So the shorting is shown over here. This is the shorting area where the voltage drops to minimum, current starts rising to the peak. Okay, causing it to get detached and next arc to start off. So for all these modes of metal transfer, the current and voltage transient study will reveals you many informations. So the next mode of transfer, that is called globular transfer, where you can see there is no shorting is taking place. Okay, it is a slightly higher current than that of the short circuit is required to get globular transfer. So we'll be going for medium current, medium voltage, so downhand position welding, and sheet thickness greater than 2 mm is recommended for globular transfer. Lesser the sheet thickness, instead of joining, cutting will takes place. And if you observe this is transferring the metal from the electrode to your molten weld puddle in the terms of globules. And globules, the size of the globules, if you observe, they are larger than the size of your electrode. So that is what is called as the globular transfer is. So a typical image is shown over here. You can observe the globular transfer mode of metal transfer. So here no shorting takes place. The size of your droplet is larger than the size of your electrode as is shown in this figure. So it's called as a globular transfer. And you can see the selection range is varying. Okay, the previous one, short circuit, is in this range. You can see the selection of globular is in a much, much higher range. So higher current and higher voltage is required than compared to the short circuit in the case of globular transfer. Okay, so same condition. So with similar 1 mm electrode is used for a comparison purpose. with the shielding gas supply as carbon dioxide. So this is the range at which the factors of current and voltage can be set in the case of globular transfer. So the next one we call it as spray transfer. So spray transfer, it is going for high current and high voltage. As a result, you can see it is again transferring in forms of globules, but it is fine globules. That is, the size of the droplet is much much lesser than the size of your electrode, and you can see at a fraction of time many number of droplets are being detached and attached into the molten well puddle. You can see the droplet, one droplet whatever is transferring, a droplet formation is also shown over here, droplet necking is also shown over here in this figure. So no short circuit on droplet transfer, well pool of low viscosity, about 100 to 300 droplets transferred per second. The spray arc only occurs with argon or gas mixtures rich in argon, then only the spray transfer will happen. So here high current and high voltage as well as high power density is also taking place. As a result, sheet thickness larger than 2 mm is only recommended in the case of spray transfer. Lesser sheet thickness normally will burn off, okay, will instead of welding, cutting will takes place. So a modified version of this spray transfer, that is called pulsed spray transfer. Okay, unlike from the previous case, okay, here also a higher current and higher voltage are being used, but that higher current and higher voltage are happening only for a small fraction of time, okay, resulting in which you will get an advantage of globular transfer and you will get an advantage of spray transfer combined over here, that is called pulsed spray transfer. So in the case of pulsed spray transfer, current and voltage are cycled between background current, okay, background current, you will have a shoulder current or voltage, and you will have a peak current or peak voltage. So one is the droplet formation, two is your droplet growth, third is a necking takes place, fourth is the droplet detachment and droplet travel in air, and it is settled into your molten well puddle. So ABC shown here are, A is your background, B is your shoulder, and C is your peak condition. And you can see over here, unlike your pulse spray transfer, here more amount of metal, okay, the more amount of metal is being detached into the molten well puddle in this case. So you can see in the video, clearly if you can observe, you can see it is 5610 frames per second and the entire video is only for 5 microseconds. Okay, it is a video taken for 5 microseconds on a frame rate of 5610 frames per second. Okay. So these are the stages of operation, and normally electronic types of power sources are used here to control or to get a waveform control. So they are called as waveform control power sources. Okay. So waveform control power sources are able to deliver the pulsed spray transfer modes. And from this, there are plenty of waveform control power sources has been generated. That all are the advancements in the case of GMAW process. So you will have surface tension transfer, you will have cold transfer, okay, cold metal transfer, CMT, and you, based on each and every power source manufacturer, based on their requirements, they have made their own waveform control technologies so that each and every material, each and every thickness of material you are able to weld by using the GMAW process. So the advantages and disadvantages of GMAW process. So advantages, very clean due to inert gas shielding used, much higher deposition rate, can weld thicker weld sections at higher weld speeds, can use dual touch and twin wire processes to further increase the deposition rate. So twin wire, rotational heads, these all are advancements happened in the case of GMAW process. So instead of a single wire, you can use twin wire. There are processes called CMT, okay, and there are various mini processes has been developed, then rotating arc, okay, these all are advancements happened in the case of GMAW process. So short and stable arc make it easier to weld, skill is not required. GMAW disadvantage, I mean the only one disadvantage is that the welding gun is quite bulky and difficult to reach small areas or corners. So nowadays the power source manufacturers has been working on that to make that also overcome by the new developments. And majority of the GMAW process, they are compatible with robotic welding, and robotic welding in majority of the industries, they are being done with the help of this GMAW process. So that is the advantages and disadvantages of the process. Plenty of studies are still also going on this GMAW process. As we can see that the future of manufacturing, as somebody is saying that it will be additive manufacturing. So GMAW process or GTAW process, if you carefully control the process well, they can be used to make additive manufacturing process also. If you search in the literatures, you can find it out, wire arc additive manufacturing process, WAAM process. So WAAM process normally employs GMAW or GTAW welding torches for the additive manufacturing purpose. So with that, I will wind up the lecture number 25, GMAW process. We will discuss the further in the coming classes. Go through the videos. Any doubts if you have, we will discuss it on the next class. Thank you.